What's going on, my PT peeps? I'm walking to the family of my fighters. I'm one eyebrow, also known as PT. Don't know if I'm winking or blinking, but I'm definitely thinking about The Walking Dead Season 10, Episode 19, and these Easter eggs, callbacks, connections, whatever you want to call them, a bunch of different things that we saw that connected previous Walking Dead episodes. So obviously, spoiler warning for all things Walking Dead, but we're going to talk about some things that you probably missed because the episode was so impactful for certain big moments. You may have missed an A and B connection plus others, but thank you guys for watching. Hit that subscribe button, help us achieve that goal of 100,000 subscribers. Now the episode starts with flowers, right? What does that mean in the world of The Walking Dead? Look at the flowers. A lot of people saw this episode and reminded them of the grove, kind of a little slow story, and then it picks up like that. But yellow flowers, look at the flowers. Did you see a connection point there? I did, and I saw other connecting points with previous episodes and seasons of The Walking Dead, and I love when the episodes do that. And we saw three burnt dead bodies, well, skeletons, more of that at the end of the video, make sure you watch to the end. But Father Gabriel had a timer. Did anyone see this connection to a previous character in season 5? He turns on the timer, which is a minute timer, by the way. That's 1 minute, about probably 10, 11 seconds to go by. Throws the timer, callback to Enid in season 5, episode 15, I believe, with Carl and Enid. And she was the first person we ever saw use a timer to distract the walkers. And that's what Father Gabriel does here. Gotta love that callback for sure. So we don't know exactly how many seconds he said it for. Maybe it was 10 seconds. It would be fitting because it's season 10. Father Gabriel finds a lone, well, one bullet casing, an empty casing. Reminds us of when he was making bullets with Eugene in the war, season 8, right? But also it is foreshadowing of the Russian roulette game with a single bullet with Maze that he would play. Now this is a skeleton, well, skeletons of a rider and a horse, and probably a rider and a horse, and it reminds me of Rick. He was on horseback, he was in danger, he was wounded, you know, it wasn't going well. We know this isn't Rick here, but this is interesting. We never really saw this before of the vertebrae, the skeleton of a horse and a person. The family dynamic, the mom, the dad, the three kids, they're a family. Aaron, Father Gabriel, and everybody in Alexandria now are a family. And I have to say, what happened here, right? This is a lineup of cars, bullet holes everywhere, and I thought Aaron was going to grab that license plate there, but I guess he didn't, and I wonder if he still collects those. But when Father Gabriel opened up the trunk, he got the food out of there, and it was just all the cans were shot up, and they were no good. But ultimately reminded me of Daryl and Beth in the trunk of another car in different circumstances, but I don't know, did anybody else see this connection or callback? I mean, Father Gabriel's looking for food and they didn't find any, and Daryl and Beth hid in the trunk for safety, different things. But also on the can, if you look at the top, you see the Best Buy date, and you might want to pause it, but I think it says May 10th, 2016. So I don't know about the shelf life of products like this. Is it 2 years, 10 years, 5 years? I mean, if it was 2 years, it'd be 2014. What year is it in the zombie apocalypse of The Walking Dead? Let me know in the comments. Jackpot play here. Nope, this was not the jackpot, was not highlighting that they're gonna find stuff here because they didn't. And also when Aaron and Father Gabriel go to this place, it says play here, lucky 13 lottery. And that's basically the opposite. Lucky 13, I don't really think of those things being the same thing. Father Gabriel chopped off the arm. And did anybody see a connection here that we saw before? Anyone, anyone? Tyrese. Michonne chopped his arm off to try to save him. Tyrese ends up dying, but it's clearly a callback to that in my eyes, right? Father Gabriel should have cut through the arm, by the way. He stopped. Just kidding. Also, the Mart T is barely hanging on. One, it's upside down. And also, it's struggling to stay on, which is symbolic of our group. This walker, it was kind of funny. It was like, ah, poof, it charged in like a bull. Big, fat, bloated walker. Reminds me of the Well Walker. And I still think the Well Walker may be one of the most iconic walkers on The Walking Dead. When they're ripping apart this walker, I think they're just trying to pull the walker out. But come on, what are they doing? Just push the walker in, right? And what's going on at the rooftop here? Why are people chained up? I guess we'll never know. But the bodies are here. This guy's still hanging on. He's chained up with his arms behind his back on the pole. People died on the mattress. They took themselves out with headshots, I guess. And, you know, then they see writing on top of the roof. I mean, so many things left unanswered. We're like, who are they writing save us for? Just in general, Civic Republic? And then we see bodies here, so we see change over time, and it just shows that the world has been falling apart for a long time, I'm guessing. Father Gabriel trips and falls in the mud, which is pretty hilarious. He got soaked in the mud. Reminded me of Megan when she was playing in the mud, the muddy walker, and it just reminded me that how she got grabbed, this walker grabbed Father Gabriel, and she didn't make it, but Father Gabriel did. And I have to say, there were a lot of different walkers in this episode. But let's go back to the muddy walker that falls on Father Gabriel. And just look at that, right? I mean, he is covered. What is going on here? That's pretty terrible. But the walker falls on him after Aaron stabs him in the head. And Father Gabriel pushes the walker off, and Aaron probably pulls him off. And as he does that, the machete cuts the walker, and the guts fall onto Father Gabriel. This is a clear Easter egg to Father Gabriel's water tower death in the comics. That didn't happen in the Whisper of War with Beta and Father Gabriel, but I see this is the water tower connection. The water tower is mentioned at least 3 times. They went towards the water tower at the end, and the comic fans were triggered like, come on, we're waiting for this water tower death. I'm not sure if we're going to get it. Another map is ruined in back-to-back episodes. Father Gabriel's map from Maggie was ruined. Daryl's map was ruined in the previous episode by water. So when in doubt, just ruin a map, and that's going to mess our group up. Now, when the group went into the warehouse, Father Gabriel and Aaron, it reminded me a lot of season 5 when Glenn, Nicholas, Aiden, Eugene, Tara, and Noah went into the warehouse there. And also, if you notice, Glenn is carrying an AK-47. And also, there was the brutal death of Noah. Kind of a brutal death for Maze in the episode, but you see Maze has an AK-47 in a warehouse, and Aaron gets the AK-47. Also, did you notice the solar recharging ability of his flashlight? When in doubt, put a solar panel on it and be like, here we go, we can use solar. Then we got these little stuffed animals. And I love the mentioning of how people were freaking out to buy them for their kids before the zombie apocalypse. But if you look closely at them, they're like spliced, genetically modified animals. You see an elephant and a bat or something there, and then a zebra and a deer or something. It's not just your normal animals. And remind me of the Terminus stuffed animals here. Kind of creepy for sure. Terminus, the good old days of The Walking Dead, right? But Father G and Aaron enjoy a nice cooked boar, which they're using that right there to cook it, which is pretty cool. They find the alcohol, which clearly says Dwayne Jones bourbon on it. Call back to Morgan Jones' son or the actor in Night of the Living Dead. Then you see the cards. 2 + 8 = 10. And also, this is the 28th remaining episode of The Walking Dead main show. I want to highlight also the putter thing here, the miniature putt golf thing. They use that or another one in the warehouse because that's what Aaron is using to play when he's drunk. One-handed, by the way, which would be really tough. He swings, and if you look closely, the ball hits Father Gabriel in the leg, and that's why he says, ow. And Aaron's like, sorry. And then Maze shows up. And it's all chaotic after this, right? We don't know how it's going to work out for our group here. And Maze is definitely a real person, but he's not a Reaper and he's not Pope. He's just a person who had some rough times, takes out the bullets, puts one bullet inside the gun. We talked about that previously as it was kind of foreshadowing with Father Gabriel finding the bullet casing. Maze puts it in, Russian roulette style. Now, also, when you notice he puts the bullet in and he spins it, you can see that the bullet is in the last part of the gun that definitely won't fire. If you look closely at it right there, you can see the bullet right there in the last spot or chamber in the revolver. So they were safe all along. Also, we knew they were safe because it's acting. It's not real life. But it just makes you think they were pretty much safe all along. But Maze gets taken out by Father Gabriel. Boom. And Aaron's shocked like, are we safe? Are we good? Right? But if you notice, when Father Gabriel puts the spiky ball, apple thing, or whatever you want to call it, Aaron's prosthetic down, and then they walk away, Father Gabriel looks at his hands, and he's like he's washing his hands, cleaning his hands off, like, yep, my hands are clean. I did what I had to do to make sure we were protected and safe. And they pick up the AK-47, and they're about to leave, but they go upstairs. And this is when it's kind of crazy. The episode gets a little crazy, right? They find Maze's twin brother that we don't know his name. Let's call him Blaze, right? We got Blaze and Maze. But that's definitely Robert Patrick. And it's just kind of funny. But either way, he's handcuffed to the poles and the keys are like right there. So he was definitely being tortured. Like, oh, you want the keys? Can't get them. But that reminded me of Merle in season one being handcuffed to the piece of steel or pipe and he never got the key. And for some reason, he decided to cut his hand off instead of cutting through the pipe or the actual handcuffs. But it's definitely a connection to Merle. And if you look at the bodies closely, they have gunshots to their head. And we saw a lot of that in this episode, right? We saw the bodies, the skeletons. But if you see the three bodies here after Blaze, well, Maze's brother, we don't know his name, but killed himself, it was foreshadowing of the three bodies right here that Aaron and Father Gabriel saw. And Aaron asked, I wonder how this happened. We'll never know. I wonder how that happened with the three bodies. They definitely know. Russian roulette. And Blaze just takes himself out. Nice foreshadowing. Then Father Gabriel takes the stuff from the shelf. And he's like, I'm getting this stuff. I'm getting something out of this, right? Aaron's all shook up, but Father Gabriel's shopping. He takes some cans of baked beans or something there. But if you look closely at it, you look at the can with the dog on it. That's definitely the same can that was being fed to Daryl in season 7. The A-OK dog food looks exactly the same. So was Maze feeding his brother dog food like Daryl? And also the two boxes of slugs here, I believe, are shotgun shells. So Father Gabriel takes the goods and he's out. Maybe he got some bandages and stuff there. So hopefully he's got something out of this trip. You see the family photos, you know, Maze's brother and his wife, and they're dead now. But to me, they're twins, right? Obviously. I just see it as a connection or Easter egg for Terminator 2. That the T-1000, who's played by Robert Patrick, has the ability to look like other people. Twins, maybe a connection, I think so. And also, if you know Gregory, who is played by Xander Berkeley, is also in Terminator 2. If you have not seen Terminator 2, definitely go check it out now. Now, you can see Father Gabriel right here. And what's the sign? B, B1. So we got a B, and we also have an A. Where is it at? Look to the right, A-O-3. Here, I'll darken it for you. A-O-3. So we got an A and we got a B. Father Gabriel's connected with it again. And you see it there to the left. They could have put whatever they wanted up here. They didn't have to put these signs up at all. And also, here's A-9. So it's on the door, on the shelving, and also a B. So will it be a connecting point with Father Gabriel, A, B, Jadis, the Civic Republic military, A's and B's. And I really hope we get some answers about the A's and B's and the Civic Republic, Rick, Jadis, and everything with that. Now, did you see the connection with Rick and Father Gabriel? When? What does he say here? What does Rick say here, by the way? What are you doing? Why are you wearing that? Why are you wearing that still? Right? And Maze says the same thing to Father Gabriel. Why do you wear that? Why do you still wear that, right? I just love it. It's a nice callback, and that's the last callback connection and Easter egg. So let me know your thoughts. Post your comments below. Do you agree? Disagree? Did I miss anything? Thank you, guys. Stay safe. Hit that subscribe button. Show us some love and support, and tell them, Daryl.